The first Grand Prix in the FIM World Supermoto Championship takes place in Spain at the circuit of Jerez de la Frontera. The best riders in the S1GP World Championship and S2 European Championship will finally do battle after the long winter layoff. And what better place to come than the home of motorcycling here in Jerez? And what is the 100th Grand Prix in the Supermoto World Championship? Short start straight into a double apex left for turn one. The second part tightening up to 90 degrees. The rider's pushing out to the outside, then kissing the curb as they go through. Then we go through a slight kink through this long right hander, hard on the brakes into this next right. Again, another double apex of a sort through a slight chicane on the way out. And then the track just tightening up at this stage here. Again, just into the dirt section, through a right, then it slows right the way down into that bank left-hander, a short burst into this right-hander here, and then on the exit, the first of the jumps. Short little tabletop, see how hard and slick it is and how blue groove it will get as the weekend wears on. Continuing through, over another tabletop, then we go left and then right, and then up onto a slight ridge, and we're back on the asphalt all over again. Through this right-hander, and then it tightens up. We start to wake our way back down towards the start-finish area now. So one more long sweeping right-hand turn into this little left, past the work area, pit lane, through the chicane, out of the final corner. We're back on the start-finish straight, and that completes the lap here at the Jerez de la Frontera. Rainer Schmidt starts from pole position on his TM, half a second quicker than Yuri Guadler and Fabrizio Bartolini on the Hondas. Fourth belonged to Mattia Martella, who heads up Road 2 with Diego Monticelli and David Jimenez, the best Spaniard rider, in sixth. Well, the lights go out, and it's Mark Rainer Schmidt, number 41, on the degassoline TM with a hole shot, on board with Yuri Guadler, as he's passed by Tony Klemm through there. Well, Rainer Schmidt leading the way at the moment. Clem second, Guadalupe third, Bartolini fourth on the Asimota Honda. Into the off-road part though, and it's Mattia Martella going around the outside and squeezes past David Jimenez. Out onto the back straight then, down past the start-finish area. And it's Rainer Schmidt, Clem, Guadalupe, Fabrizio Bartolini. They are your top four as we go on board with Yuri Guadalupe on the L30 racing machines. He tries to pass Tony Klemm just ahead of him. Looks like he's trying everything he knows to get by the Finn. Back into the off-road part though. Once again, a little bit tight through there, but everybody getting through safe and sound this time. There's Mark Rainer Schmidt. Well, it's been a perfect weekend for him so far. He was fastest in the free practice, fastest in time training. He started from pole position, and here he is leading race one and a fight for 12th here, a little bit further down. Zoe Parra and Frederik Eriksson. No such dramas for this guy, though. Rainer Schmidt looking very relaxed, it has to be said. So the degassoline motorsport rider just able to pick his lines at will, and he's just cruising through the field at the moment. A little bit of a battle further down involving Luca Sciaglia and Giovanni Busai. But here's Mattia Martella and Bartolini. Martella now is in fourth place. So the number 53 finding a way past the Asimota Honda, of Bartolini. back on board though with Yuri Guadalupe, still in third, still trying to find a way. Past Clem there in second, just ahead of him. Oh, and he loses the front end, goes down. So Guadalupe then picking himself up with, well, not even half the race gone. Back with these two though. Bartolini still trying to find a way through. Abel Urizabarena, he goes out. They're just outside of the points, not going to get any points there either. So the number 25 will have to wait till next time out. But Rainer Schmidt, though, he is leading the way. Incidentally, he was victorious in race one. Ahead of Guadalupe and Tony Clem. So it'll be interesting now to see how the podium shapes up, with Guadalupe crashing out when he did. That's Matthew Ford Dunn, the young Brit. So not having the best time in this second race. But Martella third, Bartolini fourth, Guadalupe just behind them, and also Diego Monticelli, the number 68. So we've got a four-way battle here now for third place, headed up by Martella. Oh, tight down the inside. Oh, and I tell you what, Yuri Guadalupe is going to lose, and he has lost a position there. Just came in a little bit too hot, caught the rear wheel of Bartolini. And Monticelli went sailing through. 71. Zoe Parrott going down. Just getting herself going again. Oh, a little bit of bar banging action going on here as well. Between Alessandro Aznica and Frederik Eriksson there, fighting over 16th place. But Rainer Schmidt, though, getting ready to celebrate, comes out of the final turn, crosses the line to take the win in race two. It has been a perfect weekend for him. So the German then, number 41, your overall winner here this weekend. Quick classification then. Rainer Schmidt, your overall winner. Clem second, Guadalupe third, Monticelli fourth, and Mattia Martella will take fifth overall this weekend. So your podium then, Yuri Guadalupe third overall, Tony Clem second, Mark Rainer Schmidt, your overall winner on the Degasoline Motorsport TM. It's the first S2 European Championship victory for him. He will obviously go to the next round as the leader, signified there by the red flag.
Thank you. I'm very happy about the European Championship with my team, the Gasoline Motorsport. My race was very good, also the first and the second, and I win. And I'm very happy for me and for my team. And I hope Jerez is very nice weather and the people like them. Perfect weekend for me. And thank you for all my supporters and my team.
Obviously, the winner of the first round, overall standings and in the championship, the same as they are here today. Schmidt, Clem, Guadalupe, Monticelli and Martella. Top five in the championship after round one.
This is my first time in the World Supermoto Championship. I'm very happy to have this opportunity in my life. I will be doing my best effort to do the greatest race. My whole life I was racing in Colombia. I started racing motocross, and I was the champion in Colombia, and 2 times the Ibero-American champion. 4 years later, I start with Supermoto. I get very comfortable with the moto. It's too rapid, too fast. Before racing, it's always play a lot. And in coming to Jesus, to God. And always before the race too, I put an amulet in the bike. So always God is with me and protect me.
like to repeat in this year. We are very pleased to hold here the Supermoto World Championship. And it has been a wonderful weekend with musical event, with gastronomy event, and all the people have enjoyed a lot with the races. And we'll expect all the people who like this, the motorcycling, stay here in Jerez, will visit us with the capital of motorcycling.
In the free practice sessions, Mauno HERMUNEN was constantly faster than his rivals, but it was Thomas CHAREYRE who sits on pole with HERMUNEN and Pavel Kamar alongside him. Row two is Lucas Holbacher, Ivan Lazzarini and Ilya Sammartin, with Monticelli, Vermeulen and Rivaglia on row three. Getting ready for the lights to go out then, race one. And Thomas CHAREYRE from the left-hand side takes a quick look, cuts across his rivals. He grabs the whole shot, HERMUNEN second, Kamar third. And as we head around the circuit through the first couple of corners, all eyes on the front of the field. Thomas CHAREYRE though leading the way, HERMUNEN in there in second place. Third, it's been a good start for Kamar. Back onto the tarmac though, and CHAREYRE leading the way on that factory TM. HERMUNEN on his X-Max. TM, headed up by Max Biaggi, the former road race champion, 125-250. So he's got HERMUNEN in his corner this weekend. There's Kamar in third. Holbacher, a good ride, good start for him so far in fourth place. Leaders trying to pull clear. The two TMs picking up from where they did last year, of course, down the start straight. HERMUNEN not quite close enough to launch an attack down into turn one, but that is the favoured overtaking place out on the circuit. Battle for third though, still continuing there with Kamar and Holbacher as they drop up onto the asphalt out of the dirt section. Just, you can see the gap there between second and third. There's fourth, Lazzarini, fifth in the background, Lazzarini on the L30 Racing Honda. Here's Asiri Kingalit, last year's European champion in S2. And he's picking himself up, just having a great ride. But he's got his hands full at the moment. No doubt about that. Got Monticelli, Kingalin, Rivaglia, Devon Vermeulen, all fighting 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th and 10th place. Battle for the lead though, Mauno HERMUNEN is closer. Down the start, finish straight, he looks to launch an attack. Will he get it done? Yes he does, the crowd erupts as well. As HERMUNEN finds a way through and leads. So seven laps complete now, and Mauno HERMUNEN, he cannot afford to make a mistake because he knows that Thomas CHAREYRE will be right the way back in there as well. Here's Holbacher, number 72, after Kamar. That's about for third place. Back with the leaders though. And it's still HERMUNEN, less than the bike length as they flip-flop through the lefts and the rights into the off-road part. Backmarker staying well clear as they let the leaders duke it out at the head of the field. Packed grandstand here this weekend. There's Ilya Sammartin in 10th. He would love to have done better for all the home fans this weekend as we go on board with him. I'm sure he'll like to do better in the second race, but out there on his own at the moment. Here's Kingalit. He's got Rivaglia and Vermeulen breathing down his neck as well in 8th and 9th place. Meanwhile, Lazzarini. He's circulating in fifth position on the Honda. It's his own team, remember, L30 Racing. He also knows that you can't win the championship in the first round. You can certainly lose it. There's Rivaglia and Kingalin and Vermeulen getting closer as well. So these three still locked together as this race draws to a close. Thomas CHAREYRE thinking about having a look at Mauno HERMUNEN. Will he be able to launch an attack in the final laps? Well, Mauno HERMUNEN, you can see how hard and slick and polished that race line is. You need to stay on there for maximum traction. And that's exactly what HERMUNEN's doing. Final lap, though. Thomas CHAREYRE, is he going to be close enough? We only have a handful of corners left. Thomas CHAREYRE pushing, pushing, pushing all the time through the left, through the right, up and past the work area, and out onto the start-finish straight. He's going to run out of time. It's going to be a win for Mauno HERMUNEN. as he crosses the line. Thomas CHAREYRE just looking down at the right hand there. I wonder if he's got a problem with the front brake, but anyway, Hermunen wins race one. CHAREYRE second, and Pavel Kamar was awarded third, but then pushed back five positions for failing a noise test. So Holbacher third, Lazzarini fourth, and Monticelli will take fifth in race one.
We had a good experience 2 years ago. We had good feeling with the bike as well, and we tried to win the European Championship. We lost it the last race about this year, and we tried to come in the top five on the World Championship. The feeling with the TM was good, but I was match friend with the team manager of MTR, and we came together and we talked a little bit about the next season and the expectations for me comparative to the MTR team. It was the same, and I felt to be better on the KTM just with the team and everything. But the bike, it's not so different, you know, the frame and the driving style on the TM and the KTM is nearly the same. The track looks really nice. Tried some laps, it looks nice, and the off-road like looks quite good. The expectation, I can stay in top six, top seven, and we see what happens. Last year, the expectations were to be the champion as well, but 2 years ago, I had a little bit problems with the pressure on the last race. I win the first heat and in Rivas Altas, and it was very nice to have the win, but the pressure became so high that I was thinking between the races that I was the champion already, and it wasn't. It is for sure, it is more tough in the S1, but I think the pressure is a little less, because in the S2, the people expect me to win and to finish every time on the podium, and in the S1, sometimes you can finish in the top five or maybe sometimes outside. And
S1GP race 2, the lights go out, and once again it's the TMs, but this time it's Mauno Hermunen. CHAREYRE tries to ride it round the outside as we go on board with Ilya Sammartin. He's in about 7th, 8th position at the moment, and charging down into turn 4, but Valerio Piedrahita too fast into the turn, takes out Vermeulen and Sammartin, who crashes, and he just gets back up. He's bewildered. Oh, and CHAREYRE goes down. So Thomas CHAREYRE goes out as well in the first left-hander in the off-road part. Well, with Mauno Hermunen leading the way, that means that number 4, the reigning champion, will have a lot of work to do now just to get anywhere near the leaderboard. But that has opened up the door and let off this guy here, the 131. Mauno Hermunen just needs to keep his wits about him now, as everyone else behind him charges back out of the dirt section onto the off-road. And it's Mauno Hermunen, your early race leader then. Lazzarini, the number 30, is in second. Holbacher, once again, the 72, in third. Here's Ilya Sammartin. So he's in 14th place after going down. He was inside the top 10, though, so he'll be more than disappointed on board. That's what it looked like from Sammartin, from out of nowhere, just getting caught and sent down the tarmac. There's Thomas CHAREYRE down the inside of Kamar. So that's CHAREYRE then up into 8th place. Well, Kamar did respond, and CHAREYRE though eventually worked his way through, and now using all of the racetrack and more. It doesn't like that slick line on the inside anymore, does he? Here's Mauno Hermunen continuing to lead the way at the moment. Lazzarini there in second, number 30, Holbacher third, Ravaglia fourth, Kingelin number 11 in 5th place, and then Devon Vermeulen just there in the background in 6th. Remember, he was almost European champion a couple of years ago. Teo Monticelli and Thomas CHAREYRE, 7th and 8th for those guys. Hermunen, though, having a slightly easier time of it in the second race at the moment. You see how easy it is to get caught out as Thomas CHAREYRE fell. Just lost the front end at the start of the race. So Mauno HERMUNEN will know by now that CHAREYRE is working his way through the field as we look back at Lazzarini, Holbacher and Ravaglia now in fourth place on that number eight machine. Monticelli, Thomas CHAREYRE and Kaymor. Three-way fight for those guys. A little bit further down the order. Valerio Pedrajita, he's in 12th position as CHAREYRE prepares to find a way past Monticelli. That'll be for 7th position. And he does go through at the end of the straight. So CHAREYRE now in 7th. Monticelli being pushed back to 8th. Kaymor 9th. Here's Verderosa, teammate to Lazzarini, who's currently in 2nd position. And there is Lazzarini in 2nd. Holbacher is still breathing down his neck in 3rd place. So this one, not over yet. Ravaglia going through in 4th. Number 8, Kingelin, just behind him in 5th place, having a much better ride this time out. But CHAREYRE is closing all the time. So Thomas CHAREYRE looking to find his way past Kingelin. Just ahead of him, number 11. Going to get good drive coming out of here. Might find a way through down the into the turn 1. Oh, gives him a nudge as well when he gets there. So Kingelin didn't know where CHAREYRE came from there. And Vermeulen looks to line himself up as well. Goes in a little bit too hot. Has to lock it up. Ravaglia and CHAREYRE, easy pickings this one for Thomas CHAREYRE. He now finds himself up into 4th place with 6 laps to go. Thomas CHAREYRE then 4th. Ravaglia 5th. Oh, Kaymor sneaks up into 5th. Into 6th place, pushing back the number 11 of Kingelin. So Kaymor then pulling clear of that battle. He now finds himself in 5th position. But here's your leader, Mauno HERMUNEN, on his final lap. And the X-Max TM rider is looking to make it 2 wins out of 2. He rounds out the final turn. A nice celebratory wheelie then for the Flying Finn as he crosses the line to win for the 2nd time of the afternoon. So Mauno HERMUNEN then, your winner of race 2. Ivan Lazzarini goes 2nd, Lucas Holbacher 3rd, Thomas CHAREYRE 4th, and Pavel Kaymor 5th, with Ravaglia, Kingelin, Vermeulen, Monticelli, and Cucharera rounding out the top 10. And the overall classification also belongs to Mauno HERMUNEN. Lazzarini 2nd, Lucas Holbacher on the podium in 3rd, Thomas CHAREYRE in 4th. Look how tight it is. 3 riders, 2nd, 3rd, and 4th, all on 40 points. So Mauno HERMUNEN then tops the podium. Ivan Lazzarini 2nd, Lucas Holbacher 3rd. As the riders receive their trophies, Mauno HERMUNEN standing there proudly in the center of the podium. Takes his winner's trophy, winning here in Jerez. He is the 100th Grand Prix winner in FIM Supermoto World Championship. He's also the points leader after the first round. That put a smile on his face.
The first race I didn't get so good start, and Thomas was first and I passed him, and it was a good move, and then I kept the lead until the end. And in the second race I got a better start and then led the whole race from start to finish. And I don't know about the rest of the season, but so far it's been really hard for me. On the pre-season we struggled with the bike setup, and because now we use Metzler tires, but they work now really good, and we had bit trouble to set up the bike, and couldn't be more happy for the team and Max Biaggi that he's helping me. And my grandfather passed away in January, so want to give this win for him.
So Mauno HERMUNEN wins then, and TM lead the way in the manufacturer standings. Honda 2nd, Husqvarna 3rd, KTM, Suzuki and Yamaha bringing up the rear. But what a great day here then in Spain to kick off S1GP 2015. Well, that's all we've got time for. Hope you can join us next time when we go to round 2 in Italy at the circuit of Ottobuono. My name's Paul Malin. Thanks for watching. We'll see you then. Bye for now.